Hello everyone and welcome back to our channel The Teacher, and in this tutorial we will talk about that how you can make your PowerPoint presentations as transparent GIF files and how you can use them as composition for your other PowerPoint projects. I mean to say, you can use these transparent GIF files as an entire composition which can be inserted into your other presentation, and that way you can save a lot of resources and hassles of managing objects and animation effects in PowerPoint. So let's get started. And last year in February 2020, I have already published a video on how to make GIF file in PowerPoint, how to convert your PPT into MP4 or GIF formats. As you can see that we have both of these videos here, and the link of these videos is also given in the video description. And here is another video that how you can crop your GIF files. You can go watch these videos to learn more about how to work with GIF files in PowerPoint. So here you can see that I am using Office 365 for Business, and this is a paid subscription product. You have to buy this. A monthly cost is around 550 rupees. And here you can see the version that I was using at that time. That is version 2002 and build is 12527. So currently the PowerPoint now I have is, if I go to the accounts, then here you can see the version, the latest one, 2102, and build is 13801. So this is the latest version, and the feature that I am going to talk about is only available in the latest release of Microsoft Office 365. Only the one thing new in this video is that how you can make your GIF files transparent. And before we begin, let me tell you that this feature will only be available in Office 365 or other version which has the option to latest upgrades of Office 365. So let me show you here. I have given these links in the video description as well. And if you want to try Office 365 for these features specifically, like morph transition and making transparent GIF files, then you can try it for 1 month free. And if you want to purchase it, then they have a lot of different plans, like two versions for home and for business, and they have specific plans for each of the version. And you can also go and buy it for one time. If you don't want to buy a yearly or monthly subscription of Microsoft 365 family or personal edition, then you can also bought this home and student 2019 for around 7,799 rupees. And be sure to check that if it support all the latest updates of Office 365. So let's get started. And here I am in PowerPoint, and before you make any of your presentation transparent, I will advise you not to place anything in the background, like no shape in the background, or never use any picture for the background. You have to remove it if you want to make your animation transparent, like this dog we have here. So if I want to make this dog animation as a transparent GIF file, so we have two slides. I don't want to convert this second slide, so I will hide it. And now if I go to file, export, create an animated GIF, then here you can see a new option here, make background transparent. If I make a check mark on this, and here I can choose the quality of the GIF file. Let's say if I choose extra large and can then click on create GIF. So here I can specify the location and name for the GIF file, and then click save. So the time of processing the GIF file can vary according to your presentation, like how many slides you have inside your presentation, which kind of transitions you are using, and which kind of object, 2D or 3D objects, if you are using in your presentation, and how many total objects are there, and which animations effect you are using. So the processing of the GIF file can take time according to that. So I have already created this one, so I will minimize everything, and here we will check for that dog animation GIF file. Here we have that. So now if I move to PowerPoint again and open a new slide by pressing Ctrl N, and here I go to layout menu and choose blank, and then go to insert picture this device, and here I move to desktop, and that dog animation in PowerPoint. Even though it is showing a black background, but when I will insert that picture into PowerPoint, it will have a transparent background. So that means that only this dog character is covering the entire slide. And if I place something behind this dog, let's say a rectangle, and send it to back, then you can see that it doesn't have any white space around the dog. And even though if you want to crop this picture, you can go to the picture format and choose crop, and you can crop them easily like this. So the benefit of using these transparent GIF files is that if you go to the animations and open animation pane, then you can see that we don't have a list of animation effects in the animation pane to animate this dog, because we have already animated it in another presentation and then converted that presentation to a transparent GIF. The another benefit of using transparent GIF in your PowerPoint presentation is that if you go to the home tab and click the select drop down button and choose selection pane, then you can see that this dog is now is only as a single object appearing on this slide as picture 4. Whereas if I go to the original presentation, and here if I show you both of the animation pane, here you can see that how many animation effect has been used to animate this dog. And if I open the selection pane of this presentation, then you can see that how many objects has been used to create the design of this dog. So to save the space in selection pane and animation pane, what you can do, you can convert your already created animations as GIF files and then use them as a separate character inside your other presentation. That way you can make more complex animation in PowerPoint. Like I can also apply another animation effect on this GIF file. Like if I go to the add animations and go to more motion path, and here I choose the left motion path. So that way I can also apply another animations to this object. Like I can also apply spin animation effect to it, set it to play previous, this one as well. Now we can do this kind of things with our GIF file as well. So let's say if I want to create an animated scene, so I can combine these kind of character into a single presentation. Let's say if I go to this device again, desktop, PowerPoint, transparent GIF that I already have exported. And let's say if I want to place these two here, that way I can combine more characters into a single presentation like this. So that way you can make animation scene in PowerPoint easily using these transparent GIF files. And I hope you will like this tutorial. Let me know by liking, sharing and commenting on this video. And you can also subscribe to my channel for more upcoming tutorial videos. Thanks for watching and have a wonderful day.